it certainly is challenging to find ways to connect with people using language that's inviting rather than language that shuts the door. And so a part of it is very much a dance, and it's finding ways to read people and connect with them just person to person often as an initial part of the interaction, and establishing a bit of rapport with them. And then as that rapport is built, you move into the conversations that perhaps go deeper and are more spiritual in nature. And sometimes it doesn't happen. Sometimes it's conversations about the weather, and that's as far as we get. And you know, for me, that has to be okay as well, because it's not around my agenda. It's around who is this person, and what for them would be a resource, and what are their needs, and what best, you know, would meet their needs. Often I find in conversation with my colleagues, they're interested in addressing spiritual issues, but aren't quite sure where to start the question. So just through the years, some of the questions that I've found helpful are questions like, it sounds like you're going through a really difficult time. Can you tell me a little bit more about that? And then actually be quiet and listen for their response. Another question that helps, especially if I sense that someone is worried or they have fears, I'll say something like, you know, when you wake up in the middle of the night and can't go back to sleep, what's on your mind? In terms of looking for ways to address issues around hope and that aspect of care, sometimes it's, you know, what do you hope for? And then what sustains that hope? So those are some of the questions that I've found helpful.